Monster, weekdays at 3 on UPN 30.
That was the craziest stuff I've ever done.
Corey Macklin sitting along ringside, ready to go with Memphis Wrestling, home of Rhythm and Bruise. Boy, it's going to be a day and a half today. We're going to go back and show you some of the highlights that took place at the Mid-South Coliseum. I'm going to get into that in just one moment because we're going to kick today's program off with highlights from the Coliseum. A big day of action today. In the ring today, you're going to see the Hot Boys coming up in tag team action. We got WWE superstars that are going to be lined up here today. Mordecai in a single match. We'll see Mordecai in action in one. And that big Matt Morgan, boy, you remember him, the big dude that showed up last week out here and was a big shock that showed up at the Mid-South Coliseum last Saturday also. Matt Morgan's going to be teaming up with Nicholas Doom. We're going to see Kevin White, the Mid-South Idol, assigned to be here today. And, of course, Jerry Lawler is going to be here. And a little surprise for you, Lawler, and what's going to take place tonight over in Walnut, Mississippi. Boy, a big lineup. Signed to be in Walnut. I understand the tickets have been moving fast over there. So if you're in the Walnut area, get down to that fire department right away and be there for wrestling action coming up tonight. Tonight, 7:30 bell time in Walnut, Mississippi. Boy, big lineup coming up here today. It's going to be a full hour, I'm telling you. Grab your seatbelt and buckle up, my friend, because we've got a ride and a half today. We're going to show you the highlights of what took place last Saturday night at the Coliseum, our fan appreciation night of Phantasm. It was a match that took place between Jerry Lawler and his girlfriend, Renee, against me in the ring one more time, and Paula Lawler, Jerry Lawler's ex-wife. And I'm telling you, this was beyond a catfight. Catfight's not even a word for this one, but we'll be showing you that one coming up. But I tell you what I want to do right now. Let's kick things off, and let's go immediately to the Coliseum. Last Saturday night, Mid-South Coliseum Phantasm. Take a look at the action. What took place? It started off with 2-2-2 and the Hot Boys, and what happened was, you know, if you saw the show last week, the Hot Boys entered the ring at the Coliseum on Saturday night, and they were standing there waiting, and there's 2-2-2 coming from the different direction. Boy, a little surprise for the Hot Boys, but when the Hot Boys finally got them there, the match continued, and man, it was a bout and a half. It was the Southern Tag Team titles hanging in the balance. It was the Hot Boys who had defeated 2-2-2. Oh, there's the Tony Tim. And one of the 2-2-2 team. And the Hot Boys, Hot Chocolate Corey Williams and his partner in there. And, man, I'm telling you, the Hot Boys came in, brought this big reputation of former tag team champions. These guys have got an attitude, and these two guys can move. They wrestled up in Nashville and in the Louisville area, up in Chattanooga. And I'm telling you, Corey Williams and his partner, the Hot Boys, have held the Southern Tag belts. But here they are defending the belts last Saturday night at the Coliseum against 2-2-2. And the former champions were 2-2-2. Not only were they fighting about those belts, man, last week, what about the haircutting that took place? 2-2-2 in the ring, Hot Boys come out with the scissors. Not only did he cut his hair of Tim there, one of the 2-2-2, but he also shaved his hair down at the Coliseum. You'll see that coming up here in a moment. Boy, I'm telling you, I've got a hunch that this one could not be over with between 2-2-2 and the Hot Boys. I just don't know. It makes you wonder, man, what did these guys come up with all of this kind of stuff from? The Hot Boys, you know, they want to jump these guys from behind. Well, I don't think they knew exactly who they were dealing with 2-2-2. They finally realized that, man, we got our hands full because these two guys are no joke, my friend. Let me tell you that. And I look at them double-teaming over there. Now, see, that's the kind of stuff that gets you hot with guys like this, like the Hot Boys. Yeah, he's putting a big boot to the back there several times of 2-2-2. Referee Bill rushes in, and there was no tag. First of all, the tag, that's an illegal move. Then they get in, and look at him just nailing away on Tim there, Tim Davidson, and his partner Flex on the outside. 2-2-2. Southern Tag Team titles hanging in the balance. He body slams him, drops the leg down on him, hooks him for one, a two. And boy, he was able to cook out of Ed, too, kicked out of that thing. And, man, I'm telling you, it was something else. It was some kind of tag team bout. There's finally a tag as the referee's looking on this time. So I guess they want to appease referee Bill Rush and say, hey, we're doing things legally here, ref. So they get the tag, and the Hot Boys man, he's over choking him on the ropes there. Referee right on top of it, though. Good job from Bill Rush down at the Coliseum. But see, that's the see is out there. Now, there's his partner choking him. See, that's the kind of stuff we're talking about that you have to look out for. And guys like these hot boys. These guys, I'm telling you, man, and Tim just found himself in a pickle over there between both of them. And he needs to get over and get a tag on his partner, but he couldn't do it. Meanwhile, into the rope, sunset flip. Look at this. He's got him down. A 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And finally, referee gets down. Man, whoa. Right back on his feet and down. Man, oh, man. What action took place? Southern Tag Team titles. The Hot Boys, the currently the champions, defending against the former champions, Too Cool 2. Boy, Too Cool 2 came in with attitude, but now they've turned into heavy fan favorites now here in Memphis Wrestling. Look at this. Flex rolls him up now. This two. He got him there. 1, 2, 3. And just like that, my friend, we've got Southern Tag Team champions. But that's not where it ended. It was a great night for Too Cool 2 because they won the belt back. There they are. And the fans there at the Coliseum cheering for them. But look at this. The Hot Boys jumping from behind. And this is the stuff I was talking about earlier. This is just ridiculous. He grabs not scissors this time, but those clippers. And look how he's just cutting the hair. Man, see, that's just totally uncalled for. Totally ridiculous. Look at that. Just a handful of hair. Look, he's got him by a ponytail full of that stuff. Grabbing the whole clippers there this time. And I'm just going to tell you this. The Hot Boys, I think, have bit off a little more than they can chew because Too Cool 2 is going to have payback for these guys. I guarantee you that. As they continue, oh, now they're making fun, just dumping all the hair. Oh, man, that's so disgusting. Yeah, let's come out of that. That's the, great night for Too Cool 2 to win the belts back, but a sour night on the ends on a sour note like that. Let's take a break. Come back. We got action in the ring. We're going to have those Hot Boys in the ring. We'll be back with that.
If you were expecting the prize van,
I know
well, this ain't it. It's the Jerry Springer Show.
You can run, but you can't hide.
He knows where you live.
Jerry Springer, weekdays at noon on UPN 30.
Need a part fast, who you call Dennis Hall? No time to fool, who you call Dennis Hall? Tight on the jack, don't be no fool. Got the hook up with just one call. Pick up the phone, who you call Dennis Hall? Then it got body parts, motors, and train. There's no poking around, every nook, every crane here. For the hard part, take my direction. For another message, he got the connection. Get hooked up with just one call. Pick up the phone, who you call Dennis Hall?
Call me!
She turned in front of me and just stopped.
And I got rear-ended at 90 miles an hour, and it told me.
They ran the red light and hit me head-on.
We know car wrecks and how to help you.
The insurance company was really rude, didn't even care.
They really didn't want too much to hear what I had to say.
The insurance company basically was ignoring my claim.
I want you to feel like it's the best call you've ever made.
I got probably twice as what I expected from him.
He put a big smile on my face when I saw the check.
I think Corby Trotz has his job down pat.
You just can't beat a country-made deal.
Right now at Country Ford, fresh shipments of 04 and 05 Ford certified pre-owned cars and trucks are rolling in. Plus, Country Ford is now your Mercury certified pre-owned headquarters. Prices slashed to below market levels. Credit problems, no problem. But don't wait. See us now while selection's best.
Whatever it takes.
You just can't beat a country-made deal anywhere.
Fear Factor, 5 days a week. Get your daily dose of fear.
Fear Factor, weekdays at 3 on UPN 30.
Here we are back on Memphis Wrestling here today, and we're going to get ready to go to action here in just one moment. But I want to tell you, stay tuned. We're going to be telling you more about Walnut, Mississippi coming up tonight, today in South Haven, also all in our round town action coming up. Let's go on over to the studio now. Bert Prentice and Troy Beasley calling the action. It's the Hot Boys former tag champions, and I got a feeling they're not in a good mood here today on Memphis Wrestling. Taking on the Cassidy Riley, Chris Michaels. Let's go to the action right here in the studio. You be it.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Whoa! Big time action. This is going to be a big tag match here today on Memphis Championship Wrestling. Because you're going to have Cassidy Riley.
Sounds like Cassidy Riley. There you go. That's the man right there. Cassidy Riley and the headliner, Chris Michaels. Here they come, folks. I've had the pleasure of watching these two gentlemen for a long time now.
And this has the makings of a heck of a team here, as today they will take on the Hot Boys right here in the studio at Memphis Wrestling.
The Barbershop Boys.
There again, Beaner. There again, a match that would sell out any arena. The Hot Boys and Michaels and Cassidy Riley.
Four true professionals. There again, I don't like the way that the Hot Boys do business, but they're four true professionals in the ring at this time.
This is, ring it, Binger. You have never rang the bell once on time in 2 weeks. Please get me a replacement out here.
Oh, my gosh. Jason Brisbane, the Thriller, has Chris Michaels in a headlock, puts him into the rope. Oh, big shoulder tackle. Leapfrog. Belly to back, holds on to the ropes, catch him with an arm drag, and another one.
Yeah, even Chris Michaels gets lucky once in a while.
That's not luck right there, Burt Prentice. That's years of professional wrestling experience.
Tags out to Cassidy Riley.
The hot shot. Oh.
From Monroe, Louisiana. Now makes his home in Nashville, Tennessee.
Reverses. Misses the clotheslines. Oh, I love that move, Cassidy.
Never
Riley
seen
does.
That before. Whoa!
Oh, my gosh. Corey Williams.
Already slipped.
He slipped.
Poor Cassidy slipped on the second rope.
With the help of Corey Williams, mind you.
Don't slipped. Be lying to my people out here. Don't be lying to my fans.
That's your job,
he
Bert.
Slipped on the second yeah. rope. I've never told a lie in my life. Corey Williams now. Total boot attack.
Wow.
Cassidy Riley. That's why they call him Hot Chocolate.
Goes for the tag. Chris Michaels saves.
Tags out to Jason Brisbane. Double
team.
Whip across.
Double elbow. Leaves Cassidy Riley on the mat. Goes for the cover. And a two count. Cassidy Riley kicks out. Looking for Chris Michaels.
Looking for Chris Michaels. Are you from Kentucky or something?
Absolutely. Proud to be. I bleed blue, baby. Goes for the leg drop, misses.
Please don't call me baby. Cassidy Riley, Jason Brisbane in the ring. Both make a tag. Here comes it. Chris Michaels.
Woo!
And Hot Chocolate and Chris Michaels.
Taking on both of them.
The Hot Boys.
Oh, big elbow to the face of Corey Williams. And a big kick.
It's a drop kick, fool.
Well, I got tongue-tied. I'm speechless. I'm speechless. I got tongue-tied at watching Chris Michaels in action.
Well, they peeled off in opposite corners. Corey Williams scoops up Chris Michaels. And a three, very clean scientific victory for the Hot Boys.
We're putting
right
it
here.
Tell me this.
Wrestling. We'll be right back after this.
Stay tuned, fans. We're going to have a special interview with our representative from Walnut, Mississippi. We'll be talking to him about a big night of wrestling tonight in Walnut.
The Birds are back in town. Log on to UPN30Memphis.com to win tickets to see your Memphis Redbirds. It's easy. Log on and win from UPN30.
Take me out to the ball game.
Event of the year is finally here, and it's bigger than ever. The 2005 Memphis in May Beale Street Music Festival. April 29th, 30th, and May 1st at Tom Lee Park. Starring The Killers. Elvis Costello. Nelly. Billy Idol. The Black Crowes. Trey Anastasio. Most Lonely Boys. Switchfoot and more. A non-stop party on the river. A three-day pass is only $45 until April 24th. Presented by Budweiser, AutoZone, and NBA Rhythm and Rims. Presented by Sprite.
Well, I can't stop loving you.
Americans have always loved their cars. But not many will tell you that they love their car insurance. Introducing Allstate Your Choice Auto Insurance. With features like accident forgiveness, and deductible rewards. Can you love your car insurance as much as you love your car? Yes, that's Allstate, Stan. Only from your Allstate agent. Are you in good hands?
I was just getting to the good part when Uncle Ernie dropped his tongs. I'd seen that look before. It was heartburn. Before you could say duck sauce, I was there with my Pepsid Complete. I told him only Pepsid Complete starts to neutralize acid on contact and keeps heartburn from coming back all day or all night. In no time, Uncle Ernie was in Mushu heaven, and I had my eye on the spicy dumpling. Pepsid Complete. Just one and heartburn's done.
UPN 30 knows what you like. Weekdays beginning at 6. Harvey, weekdays at 6.
And we're back. Memphis Wrestling. I tell you what, something happening all over this crowd today. I don't know what you've done to them, Beaner, but
I love them.
They are crazy and they are wild.
It's a good crowd. It's a good crowd here every week.
Come to see me?
No, I certainly didn't come to see you. I think they came to see Troy Beasley.
Whoever that is. We got a big match coming to the ring now, ladies and gentlemen. I'll tell you what, it's going to be. You hear the music. You know what that means. The fans know what it means. Bill Rush is in the ring.
Here he is, the man, Lance Cade.
There again, just a superior athlete.
The crowd completely behind him before the match even starts.
This is a match that could main event in any arena across the country, I'm telling you.
That's right.
As he's going to take on
the man Mordecai.
One of my favorite wrestlers.
Well, I can't stand him personally. Lance Cade's a good guy, though.
Well, you're a Corey Macklin fan. What does that have to
do? You're right. Love Corey Macklin.
And he is the Southern Heavyweight Champion.
He stole that from King Mabel, first of all. Barely scratched past last week at the Mid-South Coliseum.
Were you in Lexington, Kentucky when that happened? I don't think so.
No, I was not, but I've read
your
reports.
Your car barely gets across
now. Oh,
you were going to make it to Lexington, Kentucky.
Here this guy goes.
It's Lance Cade and Mordecai here on Memphis Championship Wrestling.
The referee checking both men, holding the belt up. This is a title match.
Don't forget, folks, Memphis Wrestling going on tour. If we come to your area, please check it out. Coming soon to Trenton, Tennessee, Covington, Tennessee. Coming back to Arkansas. We love all the great fans in Arkansas. Ring the bell, Beaner. How many times he got to tell you? South Pittsburgh, Tennessee. Big fundraiser for the Tennessee State Troopers coming up. Man, two big monsters. I tell you, both of these guys are under contract to World Wrestling Entertainment. And I can see why. But Cade's a big, big, big kid.
Cade's just coming back off an injury. Cade's got him in the corner. Clean break. It looks like, nope, Mordecai's not going to do it. There you go. Pushes him back. Getting pumped up, Cade is.
Don't forget, folks, this afternoon there is wrestling at 2 o'clock in South Haven, Mississippi, and then the big one tonight in Walnut, Mississippi.
You going to be there, Bert?
You better believe I'm going to Walnut, Mississippi tonight.
I'll stay home then.
We'll be in the corner of Jerry the King Lawler, I hope. Make sure that old Grady isn't up to his old shenanigans down there in Walnut. Mordecai has Cade back in the corner.
Clean break. Nope. Oh, blocks the punch and gets him back. And he rolls out of the ring. Looks like Cade's going to chase him.
Mordecai doesn't know he's on the floor.
Oh.
Taking it out on the floor. Mordecai, Lance Cade, two absolute
big elbows to the face.
Monsters.
Here they come over here.
They're at the announce table.
Oh, slams him into the desk here. Throw him in a bird or something.
Goes into the table. Lance Cade, absolutely in control of this. Throws him back in the ring right now.
And Morgan, Mordecai catches him as he comes in and is working him over big time. He's got him in the corner.
Just when you think you got Mordecai in trouble, that's when he will always surprise you. And that's why he is the Southern Heavyweight Champion. And that's, of course, why there is a long line of people wanting a shot at the Southern Heavyweight Championship. Because if you are the Southern Heavyweight Champion,
big elbow to the
face. Target on your back, and you're making some strides in professional wrestling.
I guarantee you, Mordecai has a huge target on his back. Awful big back to have a target on. But people, a lot of people shooting for him. Look at him grabbing the hair. Another boot to the chin. Goodness. Choking him. Does this man have a technical move in his repertoire at all? Does he know how to technical wrestle?
You know, for all the great fans that like to go on the road with us, we are in Nashville, Tennessee tonight. Memphis Wrestling invading Nashville tonight. This downtown stadium in. We'd love to.
I'll be there.
Beautiful trip to Nashville. Memphis Wrestling, the wrestlers going all over.
Everywhere. Taking back the territory. I'm glad to see it.
Say, that's one thing you got to really admire Jerry the King Lawler about. Not only does he do Monday Night Raw, and he's the greatest that's ever done it, but I mean, he will be in South Carolina one night and Mississippi another night, and then in California, and then in Canada, and then in England. I mean, the King has not slowed down one step.
I don't have too much to say kind about his dirty tactics, but the man is passionate about the business, and he's a hard worker, probably one of the hardest workers in the business today.
Dirty tactics, you don't get out much, Beaner. I'm glad you won't be back. Folks, if you'd like to apply for the spot of the announcer to sit next to Bert Prenzer, please give me a call.
And who would want to?
You would make me want Brian Tegman back. That's amazing.
Mordecai. Lance K. blocks the punch.
Match they've had here.
An awesome match. It's a battle of
another one.
I think it needs to be
delivers a punch of his own.
I think it needs to be dubbed Battle of the Beast. Working, Mordecai. Irish whip into the ropes. Big elbow goes down, does Mordecai.
Kate has not been successful, though, in rendering, well, he might have done it here.
There you go.
In rendering Mordecai.
Oh, big DDT. The man could be done.
He's close.
Oh! Lance Kate gets the win. We have a new champion, folks.
Are you kidding?
We have a new champion,
folks. His foot was on the rope. No. His foot was easily on the rope.
That foot was put up there after that.
No, it was not.
He this
absolutely,
is absurd.
Absolutely it was. Yes, ref. Yes, ref.
Lance Kate should be the champion.
Yes. Yeah, restart the match, Beaner. Hit the bell. Absolutely. Absolutely.
Oh.
And Mordecai.
Mordecai gets
a slap in the back.
He had something in his
tights. A simple slap in the back. And pins.
Oh, my gosh.
And there you have it. And still, Southern Heavyweight Champion, Mordecai.
Boy, big match that. A big WWE superstar, Southern Heavyweight Champion. He still reigns. Mordecai looking good here today on Memphis Wrestling. Take a quick timeout. When we come back, we got tag team action. Kevin White and the Mid-South Idol. We'll be right back on.
What's boogie?
Chewing gum is really gross. Chewing gum I hate the most.
Walter Whitney is in for a little surprise.
Hi, Daddy.
Denzel Washington in Carbon Copy.
Saturday at noon on UPN 30.
Are you tired of wearing food in your lap? Does that old-fashioned TV tray have you painfully hunched over? When you need to get closer, there's TableMate. TableMate makes whatever you're doing more comfortable. Its ingenious design allows you to sit back, relax, and slide the table right up to your body. You'll love getting close to TableMate. Whether it's eating, reading, or writing, TableMate will serve your family well. Ouch, cross-leg trays force you to the edge, but TableMate slides to you for more comfort. It easily adjusts to 6 different heights and 3 comfortable angles. It's like having 18 tables in one. TableMate's extra-large surface transforms from a kid's art easel to a yummy snack server in a snap, converts from a convenient card table to the most comfortable laptop workstation you'll ever find. And when you're done, it folds flat for storage or stacks for easy access. TableMate is extremely lightweight, yet strong enough to hold up to 50 pounds and still slides with the touch of a finger. Amazing! Use TableMate to tailgate, poolside, on the boat or RV. It's the most portable table you'll ever use. You could spend over $250 on different tables to do what just one TableMate can, but you won't pay that. Call now and get the incredible TableMate for only $29.95. But it gets better. For our special TV customers, we'll also include this remote control organizer, a $20 value free. It's ideal for keeping all your remotes in one safe place. It conveniently fits over any armrest and even stores your TV books and snacks. Yours free. TableMate comes with a lifetime replacement guarantee. If it ever breaks, buckles, or bends, we'll replace it free for life. You get the TableMate, remote organizer, and the lifetime guarantee, an $80 value, all for just $29.95. And when you call, ask how to get a TableMate free. Call now.
Call 1-800-874-2800 to order your TableMate for $29.95 and find out how you can get another TableMate free. This incredible offer won't last. Call 1-800-874-2800.
Okay, here we are back on Memphis Wrestling. The home of Rhythm and Blues is going to get back in that very ring and see more action. But let's take a look at our Roundtown action. It starts today, this afternoon. Boy, a big festival taking place. The South Haven Spring Festival that's taking place in South Haven. And Memphis Wrestling is a part of it. Boy, you can't have a big festival and don't invite the big boys of Memphis Wrestling, can you? There's going to be action all over the place. They've got ride and food and fun and games right off of Goodman Road right there in Snowden Park. Going to be a big day of action. Bring the family out. That's a great family festivity. It's a big event that's taking place in South Haven for a long, long time. And Memphis Wrestling, proud to be a part of it. There's going to be a ring set up and a few matches going to be lined up today, this afternoon, immediately following Memphis Wrestling, coming up this afternoon at Snowden Grove Park right in South Haven. And then tonight, we've been telling you about it, and we're going to be talking to Grady Watson coming up here in just a few moments about the action coming up tonight in Walnut. But Walnut, Mississippi, boy, you see the big lineup for Walnut coming up tonight. Reggie be fine, and I'm sure that Private Precious will be close by with him because I'm sure he can't go far from having him hanging close on his arm. He's got him and Jerry Lawler, and that whole Lawler's army is going to be there. And, well, on the other side, you're going to see Big Shock there and Coco Ware and Kevin White. Going to be a big lineup. The superstar, Bill Dundee, it's all tonight. Walnut, Mississippi, there at that good-looking fire department. Boy, what a beautiful building that is. There in Walnut, tickets on sale at the Walnut Fire Department. Get down there for the action. Well, let's get ready now, and let's go back to the ring for more action. We've got tag team action coming up. The team of Nicholas Doom and that big Matt Morgan. Boy, big dude from the WWE. He's here today on Memphis Wrestling. We're going to see him in action, taking on the team of Kevin White, Mid-South Idol. Let's go back here in the studio for all the action.
Great action here, Beaner.
The first matchup, here they come out right now. Nick Doom and the man, Matt Morgan.
He is the man. Matt Morgan, an absolute, genuine monster.
He's a beast, I tell you that much.
My God.
How tall is he? 7 foot, 300 and... My gosh, a big, big boy.
Nicholas Doom and Matt Morgan. Gonna be... Tell you what a match.
What is
their opponents got two very credible opponents. One's a little pudgy, and one's a little overweight.
No, I'll tell you.
And why these people love them. These girls go nuts when the Mid-South Idol.
There they are, right there. Kevin White and the Mid-South Idol. He's not at all pudgy. He's a thick boy. He's been in the gym, but
he's not pudgy. He's a thick boy.
No, he's okay. It's mass. It's Matt. He's been in the
gym.
Like
girls should date. They're not
whatever.
Fat, they're thick.
No. Big boned, dude. But hey, he's been in the gym and he looks good. I tell you, I don't know why you would ever say he's pudgy. Boy's got a lot of mass. It's muscle, not fat.
I've seen your wife. I'd go for
oh,
thick.
Oh, my goodness.
Kevin White and the Thick.
He's the Mid-South Idol, Bert.
The Mid-South Idol, Stan Lee. Action here today against Matt Morgan and Nicholas Doom. Jerry Calhoun just ring the bell, Beaner. And we're off and running. The Mid-South Idol.
Bert, maybe you know a little bit about
Nicholas Doom.
What is up with his sick, demented mind? The guy's into pain and shooting darts in his back and stuff. What's that about?
Nicholas Doom taking it right to the Mid-South Idol.
Irish whip into the ropes. No, he reverses it. Oh, big spinning kick.
Incredible maneuver by the Mid-South Idol. I tell you, the Mid-South Idol has certainly caught the attention of a lot of promoters around the country. He's staying very busy. Traveling. I know they love him in Chattanooga,
they
Tennessee.
Sure
and they love him. He recently went to Chicago, Illinois. This kid's going to be a big-time player, I tell you what. Kevin White, I tell you what, no slouch in the ring right now. Nice takedown on Nicholas Doom.
Working on the arm of Nicholas Doom. It's the way to take it back to technical wrestling. Pick a body part and work it. Oh, big body slam by the Mid-South Idol. Oh, my goodness.
Very agile for a thick man.
Well, I sense a little sarcasm there.
I'm
sure
he's trying to lose a little bit of weight.
Irish whip into the ropes. Big clothesline by the man. Oh, my goodness.
My gosh. I'm speechless. My gosh.
He did almost take the man's head off. Man, they got a little bit of help over here. My goodness.
How the Mid-South Idol's even.
That chop to the chest rang through the studio.
Matt Morgan just stepped right over the right over the top rope.
Boot to the face.
Just kicks him in the head for good measure.
I guess that was a scientific wrestling move.
That's a handful of hair that covers almost his whole head. Mid-South Idol fighting back. Get a little fire there.
Oh, big headbutt to the... My goodness.
I want to remind all you great fans, tonight in Walnut, Mississippi, we're coming to Walnut. Old Grady sold a ton of things. Jerry the
Sidewalk Slam.
In Walnut. Of course, this afternoon, a big card in South Haven. We're going all over the place.
Two big cards today, like you said, South Haven and Walnut, Mississippi. Be sure to come check us out, folks. Oh, headbutt to the chest. I don't know that I've seen that move too many times.
Next Friday night, we got a big night of wrestling in South Pittsburgh, Tennessee. Coming to Soddy Daisy, Tennessee. All over the area.
We're everywhere.
Memphis wrestling is absolutely exploding.
I think it's back, Bert. It's
the
back to the
territorial wrestling company in the country.
That's right.
Nicholas Doom having his way with the Mid-South Idol, Stan Lee.
Oh, runs him into the boot. The turnbuckle wasn't enough. He had to put him in Matt Morgan's big boot.
This Morgan is just looking at him is so overwhelming, and the guy is just absolutely.
Well, I don't like the man much, but his trunks say it all. The blueprint.
Nobody home. The idol regaining his senses. Nobody's home.
Misses the kick.
Kicks
him to the back of the head.
Idol, let's give the kid some credit. He's got the 7-foot man down.
Tags him White. Here he comes.
The tag. Yep, it's a fit. Kevin White tags in. A little bit of train wreck going on here.
Taking it outside.
Outside the ring. Mid-South Idol.
Here they come over here. Oh, my gosh.
Oh, my gosh. The camera didn't get it, but, folks, I swear to you, Matt Morgan sent this kid at least 11 feet in the air on a big choke slam, and your winners, Matt Morgan and Nicholas Doom.
When we come back, we go to the Mid-South Coliseum for the match that took place with myself and Paula Lawler against Jerry Lawler and Renee. When we come back.
Are you tired of wearing food in your lap? Does that old-fashioned TV tray have you painfully hunched over? When you need to get closer, there's TableMate.
TableMate makes whatever you're doing more comfortable. Its ingenious design allows you to sit back, relax, and slide the table right up to your body. You'll love getting close to TableMate. Whether it's eating, reading, or writing, TableMate will serve your family well. Ouch, cross-leg trays force you to the edge, but TableMate slides to you for more comfort. It easily adjusts to 6 different heights and 3 comfortable angles. It's like having 18 tables in one. TableMate's extra-large surface transforms from a kid's art easel to a yummy snack server in a snap, converts from a convenient card table to the most comfortable laptop workstation you'll ever find. And when you're done, it folds flat for storage or stacks for easy access. TableMate is extremely lightweight, yet strong enough to hold up to 50 pounds and still slides with the touch of a finger. Amazing! Use TableMate to tailgate, poolside, on the boat or RV. It's the most portable table you'll ever use. You could spend over $250 on different tables to do what just one TableMate can, but you won't pay that. Call now and get the incredible TableMate for only $29.95. But it gets better. For our special TV customers, we'll also include this remote control organizer, a $20 value free. It's ideal for keeping all your remotes in one safe place. It conveniently fits over any armrest and even stores your TV books and snacks. Yours free. TableMate comes with a lifetime replacement guarantee. If it ever breaks, buckles, or bends, we'll replace it free for life. You get the TableMate, remote organizer, and the lifetime guarantee, an $80 value, all for just $29.95. And when you call, ask how to get a TableMate free. Call now.
Call 1-800-874-2800 to order your TableMate for $29.95 and find out how you can get another TableMate free. This incredible offer won't last. Call 1-800-874-2800.
Here we are back here at the desk, sitting here at the ringside of the action, and boy, just total reminiscing everything that's been taking place here. It's pleasant to be back here and be a part of Memphis Wrestling and be sitting here. Thank you for inviting us and welcoming us into your home here today for Memphis Wrestling, home of Rhythm and Brews. We got another match coming up still later on here today in action, and we're going to be talking to everyone that's talking about Walnut, Mississippi. But what I want to do right now is I want to go take a look at some footage. I stepped in the ring one more time, and as far as I'm concerned, it was my last time wrestling, but I wanted to prove a point to Jerry Lawler, and that was that you can't just push me around, Lawler. You may have the right string, but it's the wrong yo-yo. I'll tell you that, Jerry Lawler, and I think I proved that. Let's go, and let's see some of the action. You fans take a look at this mixed tag team battle that took place at the Coliseum.
Man, I'm telling you, that's the action took place down there last Saturday night at the Coliseum. And I want to tell you this. I made a visit this past Monday to my doctor, Doc Sammons, and my lip notes. If you can tell, my voice is a little sore, and I apologize for those of you at home that have to bear listening to this groggy voice here today on Memphis Wrestling. But I wanted to just be a part of this program here today, and it's just great to be back, sitting here in this seat, sitting here at this desk, talking to all the fans. But I went and saw my doctor, Doc Sammons, this past week, and my lip notes were injured. And you know what? I had to get two shots from my doctor Monday morning. And it wasn't a pleasant feeling, Jerry Lawler. And, you know, it's still a little swollen. And, you know, it all happened when you knocked me over that top rope at the Mid-South Coliseum. But, you know, something that was even worse than that, I'm a man. I can take it. That's fine. My shoulders are broad enough. I can handle it, Lawler. And I'm not crying, and I'm not whining about it. But I've showed you that I'll step up to you toe-to-toe and that I'll fight you, Jerry Lawler. And you know that I will. You know I won't back away. I told you that I'm no Lance Russell, and you ain't going to treat me like you used to treat Lance, coming out here pushing Lance around, a 75-year-old man that's given his heart, earned time and blood and energy for this business. And you just used to just completely insult Lance Russell. And I got a whole lot of respect for Lance. I love him to death. He taught me a lot of what I learned sitting behind this desk, Jerry Lawler. But what you did to a 105-pound woman was totally uncalled for, Lawler. Totally ridiculous. To pick Paulo up and pile drive a woman. I guess that makes you feel real big, Lawler. To pick her up, pull her head down, stick her head between your legs, and pile drive her right smack dab in the middle of the ring in front of those thousands of people in the Mid-South Coliseum. That should make you feel about this big, you know it? But that's what you are anyway, Lawler. You're just about that big, and I'm sick and tired of you anyway. But I will tell you this, King, it ain't over. I know that.
The Birds are back in town. Log on to UPN30Memphis.com to win tickets to see your Memphis Redbirds. It's easy. Log on and win from UPN30.
Take me out to the ball game.
That's fun to listen to. WDIA.
Go! 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 Whoa!
Gotta eat.
Kick it.
Rally's Pepper Jack Double Cheeseburgers are going as fast as you are because they're just $2 for $3. So go for it. Get two Pepper Jack Double Cheeseburgers for $3.
Go!
Go to Rally's because you've got to eat.
Go! Go!
You got to eat.
This year we're going for the go.
Will Sid and Regina dance all over Steve and LaVita?
If I wasn't saved, I could have been in a Rump Shaker video.
Find out next Steve Harvey Show.
Monday at 6:30 on UPN 30.
Well, here we are back on Memphis Wrestling, and I'm still trying to host this show today here on Memphis Wrestling. And being a host and being an announcer, I'm sorry for getting my feathers ruffled. But anyway, let's get back to the action. Tell you what I want to do now. Let's go over to the other studio because Bert Prentice is standing by, and that whole Lawler Army thing, he's got Jerry Lawler with him. And I understand they requested some time. Well, let's hear what Lawler's got to say. But I hear one thing that's going to take place tonight in Walnut, Mississippi, and I think they're talking about that. Let's go over. Can we take a look now, Kim, at that?
With me now, ladies and gentlemen, the pride of Walnut, Mississippi, Grady Watson, where tonight, a big night of wrestling at the Fire Hall.
Yes, sir. We've been working real hard for the night at the fire station there in Walnut. We're giving a bit of fit wrestling match, and it's already a big crowd, and I'm going to be in the ring tonight in Walnut, Mississippi.
Grady, you're going in the ring?
I'm going in the ring tonight.
I know the King Jerry, the King Lawler's going to be there. We're excited about that. The whole army's coming. I'm going to come watch it.
Bill Dundee will be there. Kevin White will be there. We'll have a big...
We don't want to mention them. We're going to talk about Jerry the King Lawler being there.
Lawler. We're going to have a good time. I guarantee you that.
Well, are you not a fan of Lawler? You got a problem with Lawler?
Well,
do you have a problem with Lawler?
No. This guy is here every Saturday sitting out in the crowd. You're right where you should be, Grady. You're out there buying a ticket, watching big stars like me wrestle. Now, I don't know what kind of crazy little match you got planned for Walnut, Mississippi tonight. But listen, we take this very serious. You don't need to be in there. Who are you going to wrestle? The fire chief or a principal or something like that? We don't need that stuff. That's silliness. And as a matter of fact, right now, Grady, I want to do something. I want to introduce somebody that has been a big, huge part in my life. A lot of people don't know, before I was actually the king of wrestling, how I got started in this business. If you read my book, of course, my autobiography, It's Good to Be the King Sometimes, you may know this story. But years ago, before I ever even had my first match, I went over to West Memphis, Arkansas, where they were having some little matches in a little theater over there, West Memphis, Arkansas. And this man right here was the promoter in West Memphis, Arkansas, Aubrey Griffith, and he gave me my very first match. Aubrey, I want to thank you. You remember that day?
I remember it well. I remember Jerry Vickers bringing him over there.
That's right.
Kind of a little skinny fellow then.
And that's right.
We were kind of wondering where to put him on or not. So I said, well, bring him out there, and we'll just kind of feel him out a little bit. You know, we'll bring him back next week. I believe that's what it was. He come out, and I felt him out a little bit. I tell you what, he's a little bit smaller, but he's done a great job. And I had a concrete floor over there, and then we'll forget. First night she was there, I remember hitting the concrete. I heard his head crack. First, we thought it was concrete, but I think it was his head.
That's exactly
right. He became one of the greatest to ever step in the ring.
All thanks to this man right here. And
wow.
Hang on a second. Grady Watson, right?
Yes, sir.
I thought I told you to go sit down.
I'm not through talking.
What?
I'm not through talking.
Said he's not through talking, King.
No, you don't know. You are through talking. Go sit down.
I'm not through talking about my match.
Aubrey, I want to apologize. This guy is from Walnut, Mississippi. We want to talk about your match. You're not gonna have a match. Look, I told you. Look at you, Grady Watson. I mean, I've seen more meat on a skeleton than you got right here. And you want to try to tell somebody that you're going to go in the ring and wrestle? Huh? No, you're not going to go in the ring and wrestle. Because real wrestlers, people like, I could beat somebody like you blindfolded, Grady Watson. You can take your fire chief or whoever it is you're going to wrestle and just sit over there, buy a ticket tonight, and watch the pros at work, okay?
You say you could wrestle me blindfolded? Is that what you said? Blindfolded?
No, I didn't say that. I said I could beat a skinny runt like you blindfolded. That's what I said, Methuselah. Go sit down somewhere.
Won't you try me tonight in Walnut? Me and you.
You don't want to get in the... Are you crazy? This man's nuts.
Well, he's a Walnutian. They're all nuts in Walnut. That's why they got the name Walnut. Because the place is nothing but four walls, and it's full of nuts like this idiot right here. Are you telling me, Grady Watson? I know what you're doing. I know what you're doing. You're trying to be the big shot in that little hick town of yours. Walnut is so small they put a mirror at one end of it to make it look bigger. And he's trying to be a big shot. Shut up! So you're saying, I know what you're trying to do. Because I said I could beat you blindfolded. You're trying to say that you would get in a match with me if I were blindfolded. Is that what you're saying?
Yes, sir.
Did he say yes, sir?
He said yes, sir.
Yes, sir, tonight.
Well, let me just say this, Grady. I know what you're thinking. If I were blindfolded, if I had a big black bag over my head or something, that I wouldn't be able to see you. I wouldn't be able to get my hands on you, and you could run around and be all happy and make a big joke, I think. But see, the truth of the matter is, Grady, even if I were blindfolded, I would be able to find you in that ring. You know how? Because I could smell you, because you stink. Everybody from Mississippi stinks, and I would get my hands on you, and I would just use my nose, and I would find you, and then I would be on you just like flies are on what you smell like, Grady Watson. So, what?
Just bring it on down to Walnut tonight. Then do back you talking up.
Bring it on down to Walnut, okay?
He's not serious, is he?
I think he really is. What? The whole crowd is screaming Grady's name. Sit down, folks. Come on.
You people don't realize how much trouble you're getting this man into. I'll tell you what, Grady. I got a match already in Walnut, but we'll add that match just so that I can prove to you that you have absolutely got no business whatsoever ever being in a wrestling ring.
If he signs a release, okay.
Yeah, oh yeah, you're going to sign a medical release. Yeah. You're going to sign a release that you'll never be able to sue me or any of my heirs or my family in any kind of way. Right. I will not be held liable. I will not be responsible for what happens to you, even though I'll be blindfolded. That's tonight in Walnut.
You better sign a release.
Oh, good gosh. Grady Watson against the King in a blindfold match in Walnut, Mississippi tonight. We want to see you there. We'll be right back after this.
On the WB Speak Sunday, its origin, a mystery. Its contents, powerful.
I could handle this. Are you kidding me?
Its effect on the Charmed Ones, unimaginable.
Do you mind? Do I mind what? Looking so psychotically perky.
It's Pandora's Box, fresh charm. Then, ex-husband, ex-wife, bowling ball.
You must have got everything you wanted in the divorce.
Fresh Big Time Challenge, after a fresh charm.
The WB Sunday, starting at 6 on UPN 30.
You travel the world. Now you must journey inwards. What you really fear is inside you. There is no turning back. If you make yourself more than just a man, if you devote yourself to an ideal, you become something else entirely. Are you ready to begin?
What a day today on Memphis Wrestling. I'm telling you, it's been a day and a half. We saw tag team action with the Hot Boys coming in here. And, of course, they weren't too happy campers here today because they lost those Southern tag team titles to Too Cool 2. But they won today in convincing fashion today in action. The Hot Boys looking mighty impressive. What about Mordecai? And what about that big slam that Matt Morgan did earlier? Let's go back our state smash of the week. Take a look at this. There it is right there on your screen. Matt Morgan just picking him up high in the air this time. He's got the Mid-South Idol high, slams him down in the mat, and I'm telling you, boy, I don't know anybody that could get up from that one. He pounded him, my friend, in that mat. And when you look and see a guy that's cut out like Matt Morgan is right there, man, just to look across the way and see him pick you up high in the air, ho, ho, ho. Whew, that's got to be a feeling and a half. South Haven coming up this afternoon for Memphis Wrestling. Get down to the Snowden Grove Park for action. And tonight, Walnut, Mississippi. I got a hunch that's going to be a big one. I understand ringside tickets are about gone, but there's still some good reserve seats and good general admission seats available over in Walnut. We'll see you next week on Memphis Wrestling. Until then, I'm Corey Macklin. Be looking for you then. Bye-bye, everybody.
Memphis Wrestling, brought to you by Country Ford, Cash Depot, and by Staten's Rental Purchase.
Thank you, Mid-South, for making Cameron Harper's Celebrity Putt-Putt Tournament a huge success.
The weather was beautiful. The turnout was great. They raised a lot of money for Ronald McDonald House. You can't beat it.
It has just been a great event.
Thank y'all so much for coming out.
Thank you.
Thanks for supporting the Eyewitness News Celebrity Putt-Putt Tournament benefiting Ronald McDonald House.
And we'll see you again next year.
Get continuous, in-depth team coverage. Plus, when news breaks out, we break in. Only on News Radio 600 WREC.
You just can't beat a country made deal.
Right now at Country Ford, fresh shipments of 04 and 05 Ford certified pre-owned cars and trucks are rolling in. Plus, Country Ford is now your Mercury certified pre-owned headquarters. Prices slashed to below market levels. Credit problems, no problem. But don't wait. See us now while selection's best.
Whatever it takes.
You just can't beat a country-made deal anywhere.